wait a minute! Falls on Ross, almost slams him to the table, the power bomb! And oh, then look at this. Look at this. Death Roberts with a moonsault to Ross. What are these guys doing out here? Wait. We're on the air right now? Really? Wait, anyway, they can join us. Before the show starts, he's got the Sioux Souls. Wait. The enforcer, and look at this. Jeff Roberts has a powerbomb to Ross Mitchell again. Ross has went through a second table. How much more can Ross Mitchell take? And what the hell is Gene Starling? I mean, we all saw what the Suicidals did to both Sex and Violence and the Mythbusters at a one-way ticket. Why are they out here doing this now? We want the enforcer to come out here. I hope he comes out here soon. Well, this could be it for Ross, Riveter, and Mitchell. I'm not saying that there's people who don't want to see this happen, because I'm sure there are a lot of people who want to see this happen. But look at this. Flying moonsault the top of all the Ross through the table. That's the third table there. And now bring in a ladder too. Oh no. This raising the level of violence they're committing on a Ross. Why are these guys doing this? Oh, look at this, there's a powerbomb, and there's Ross to the fourth table. Well, no, Steven, I can't really say that Ross Riveter didn't deserve this after what he did in previous weeks. After what he did to Sombra, the Destroyer, and the Mythbusters, and Pimps and Thugs. But still, I mean, that's a man right there. You can put him on the hospital for doing this to somebody. The suplexes him to the fifth table. Oh no, he has him throttled, and he's also just choke slams him through a sixth table. And if the Suicidals keep this up, they're going to consume the UWA's yearly stock of tables, and if the enforcer doesn't change his mind and prevent the Suicidals from stopping this carnage. Man, what a way to kick off Assault. No one ever thought this would ever happen. Look at that, a flying double elbow drop to the table, and now Ross with the eighth table. Battle St. Louis matchup, Pandamonium for Tech Toss, man, it's gonna be huge!
Dollar bills, leave your thrills out here. Welcome everybody, you're watching UWA Assault, coming to you live from Portland, Oregon, and we're going to kick things off tonight with the fourth qualifying match of the International Icons Invitational, and wait a minute, he's back, Spike Spiegel from Cowboy Bebop, and return to the UWA! You see, this is huge. I mean, wait, you remember calling great matches with me of Spike Spiegel in his illustrious career. And in 2002-2004, he's had epic matches with, I mean, who can ever forget his tag team partner, Jet Black? Who can ever forget those vicious wars they've had with the McDougal brothers? And who can ever forget that classic, that epic tag team war at Pandamonium 4? And Spike Spiegel, in here, he's gonna be a shoo-in to be a finalist in the International Icons Invitational. Wait a minute. That face looks familiar. I've played the games. That's Scorpion! The Mortal Kombat series! Oh my. Spike is in trouble. He's going to go up against Scorpion, who some say he's undead. Look at that, Spike, he's sizing up his opposition. And what's going through his mind right now? He's going to go in the ring with Scorpion. And Scorpion can do almost anything. He personifies it. He personifies Mortal Kombat. He's been in so many fights of this life, this man should be no different. This man is so powerful and so precise that when you face him, he throws a spear at you to make him come to you. And instead of having you come to him, he just gets at you, get over here! And now this fight is finally underway.
Well, Rock Jr. besides the past few games, we're yet to see what Scorpion has to offer in wrestling. We have seen Spike Spiegel exposed in the past, so we'll see what Scorpion has. So far, he's off to a great start. Seeing as he's getting the upper hand on Spike right now. Got him motionless in the corner there. Hung up on the ropes, but Spike is bowing back here. A leg jack takedown there. Oh no, Spike. Oh my!
Well, you see, I'm just going to jump right to it. Obviously, those of you who saw One-Way Ticket, you all know that was a great match. That was an epic night, full of surprises, full of twists and turns, and we'll have all the fallout of that great night here tonight. And of course, I want to thank all you folks out there watching and joining us on our 7th edition of Assault. Of course, Rock Jock here with New Steven on the broadcast position. We promised you tonight will be a huge match. We got a double main event for you tonight. But before I get into that, back at One-Way Ticket, we were all shocked. I mean, we saw the return of Vicious. And if Vicious didn't come at the time, at the way he came, Vampiro would have undoubtedly won Money in the Bank that night. But you want to wonder who won Money in the Bank? It was none other than Samoa Joe. What a triumphant return it was for him as well by winning Money in the Bank. And he won the contract, and he had that contract signed right after the match, and he decided to challenge Von Krieg for the UWA Championship, and we've been waiting a long time to see that match finally happen, and it's going to happen at Pandamonium in the main event. It's not going to be any normal match. It's actually going to be and contested inside a Hell in a Cell match. I mean, nothing gets more brutal and vicious and chaotic than a Hell in a Cell match. And the Razor says even more, Samoa Joe said that if he was going to beat Von Krieg and win the title at Pandamonium in the Hell in a Cell match, then Samoa Joe has agreed to walk away from wrestling for good. Back to the action here. Look at this. Look at this offense by Spike. This is the offense that brought Spike to the dance. This is vintage Spike right here. He's using the ring as an unofficial ally And he's going to do that a lot to keep down Scorpion long enough to get a pin. Because believe me, going up against Scorpion is not going to be an easy task for Spike Spiegel if he wants to be in the finals at Pandamonium.